Wow! That's one of those plays that you call, and everything seems to happen exactly as it's scripted in the playbook.
Elohim never had time for donuts. The beat go ham, no time for cold cuts. The game like Big Fish came to join up. Yeah, I'm still independent. Ain't sold a million records yet. Used to be on my checklist. Big diamonds don't need a necklace. Look, we built the sound like it's double speed Tetris. I cannot build without guarding it. We built the sound, you can't copy this. I never brag, it's just confidence. I never rap for your compliments. I wrote this one for the indie grind. If you ain't signed on the dotted line. Can't buy my soul with no dollar signs. The industry so full of troglodytes. I don't follow trends. Run it up.
DC,
be the end of me. No, probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I
shake, snake, Tennessee. Let's go. Don't make me jog your memory. I did upgrade you, then upgraded the world. How they forgetting me? Please make it make some sense to me. How you talking about the greatest? Still ain't greatest. Mention me. Them bands, I want the symphony. 15 in it, went instantly. Lately I've been catching plays, it's like it's meant to be. I got rich in the pandemic, meant to be. Don't do too much, I keep it simple. You clout chasing, trying to make the people feel you. Boys need to slow it down, I'm talking real screw. Penthouse at the top with the clear view. Oh, look, I don't like your energy, I don't like it. I don't like the fake handshake, snake, Tennessee. You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no, probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake, Tennessee. Let's go. You not my kind, not no kin to me. Heard you told my girl about all of them that's DMing me. Why they hogging up the recipe? Heard they talking like I can't let Ken Wallace get ahead of me. Know your heart full of jealousy. All that acting tough, damn, this must be a parody. Okay, 101 ain't no comparing me. Okay, wait, 2-on-2, that's like for two. They be sharing me. Okay, they working like the red dude. Rent, got them doing. That's what I'm into. Yeah, if I'm in it, then I own it, not a rental. No, I've been plotting on the lamb and the Benz coupe.
Yeah,
ooh.
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't like your energy. I don't like that. I don't like the fake handshake, snake, Tennessee. You an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no, probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake, Tennessee. Let's go.
Got so many memories that I made on Casket Road. I done gained the world, I ain't never sell my soul. This is God-given, so I thank him as I go. Hate to sound conceited, but I know. Crazy thing they f*** with me. Yeah, crazy thing they f*** with me. Run up on me, baby, show you gon' see. Yeah, God power for my head and my...
Don't worry.
NFL 23, and we'll see who rules the skies in today's battle. It's the Ravens and the Jets, and it's coming up next on EA Sports.
Well, we are about a $50 camera ready from Midtown Manhattan in MetLife Stadium in East.
East Rutherford.
Today, it's the opener of a new NFL season between the Baltimore Ravens and the New York Jets. Up in the booth with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, here for the start, folks, of another NFL. The Ravens offense ready to put the preseason behind them and begin this 2022 campaign. And one of the folks we'll be watching is this man. Zero, and this is not the way to start a drive.
Delayed game.
Oh. The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted.
Still first down.
Jackson down. That's into the hands of the tight end Boyle. And he'll be out of bounds up past the 10-yard line. Second and 10. Now it's Jackson. And that nearly an interception here on his opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
Tremendous coverage there. Just did not catch the football and complete the interception. But what do they say all the time? If he had really good hands, he'd be playing offense.
On third down, Jackson. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. He's got the first down and more. Down the left sideline. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A big play there. 88 yards. And the Ravens are on the board here first in the season opener.
So how's this for a big play in your debut with a new team? We've talked about him. He's been underutilized to this point in his career, but he's definitely got home run ability. And we saw it on display right there.
Baltimore set to take over here for their second possession of the game. Perfect start to the season on their first drive last time out, able to find the end zone. Now we'll see if they can make it 2 for 2 here in week one. On first and 10, it's Jackson. And that nearly intercepted. The free safety rolling into position, almost had it, but it's second down. So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Now Jackson. And it's knocked away and incomplete. See, you've got Manny Kalupe calling the shots for this offense. His second year as an offensive coordinator in the league. How do you see his crew on this side of the ball performing this year?
Well, partners, you and I both know, and everyone else around the league, Manny was a popular head coaching candidate for this year. But he told all the teams he was interested in remaining a coordinator for a bit so he could continue to grow in the job. As far as his offense this year, he's really optimistic about what they can do because he loves the talent on that side of the ball. And one other thing, Manny Kalupe, a young, bright offensive mind, he'll be a head coach before long when he's ready to do it.
Jackson on first down. And this is incomplete. Very lucky to get that one back. That nearly picked. It's second down now. So second down and 10. Once again, they'll go from the 40. Jackson. And this one too low.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route. And that made it a lot tougher. clean throw his way.
He's going to rifle one deep left side. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Now, that's a good bounce back after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive. Just one first down permitted, and then out. Obviously, no loss of confidence with that defense, and now they get to turn it back to their offense.
We'll remind you that coming up tonight, the first Sunday nighter of the new season, and how about this for a matchup? The Buccaneers and the Cowboys from Dallas, 8:20 Eastern. Then tomorrow, Monday night, just one game here in week one this year, and it'll pit the Broncos and Seahawks as Russell Wilson makes his Bronco debut. And of course, where is it? Seattle. Coincidence? We'll let you decide. Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. On second and 10, Jackson. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. So the new weapon on the outside getting involved here in the regular season. Remember, limited production for him in his first 4 years in the league, but he's getting a shot to really be a key part of the rotation. Charles, what do you think that he brings to the table?
Brandon, I think he's got all the tools, but what he hasn't had is opportunity. He's been behind a lot of players along the way, sort of relegated to being the fourth and fifth option. Now he moves into a role that's higher up in the pecking order, so he wants to take what he's learned and apply it to this new situation.
Catch number 4 for him on the afternoon, and it'll give him a first down.
Well, you know, partner, we talked to this young man earlier in the week, and he went on and on about how lucky he felt he was to have spent his first 4 years in the league with the Kansas City Chiefs, and how starting his career in that offense really set him up to be a starter now.
Well, think about it. He's sharing a film room and a practice field with Tyreek Hill and Travis Kelce, two of the most dynamic weapons in the NFL. Not to mention Patrick Mahomes and Andy Reid, a dream duo, a quarterback and coach. He said the lessons he learned over his first 4 years have set him up for success now that he's climbed the ladder in this league.
A good pick up there, 26 yards.
Yeah, nice catch there in his debut. This is a guy who came over in free agency. He's never really had an opportunity to be a volume receiver before, but it appears he's going to get that chance here, and he picks up a first down.
So in Jet territory now. Here's first and 10, down at the 31. Now here's a throw. It's complete. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
I can't help but chuckle a little bit because at this point, it can't be a surprise to anyone in the building who's going to get the ball. They just keep feeding him over and over, and he just keeps on delivering.
From the red zone now, here's Jackson on first down. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete.
I'm really liking what I'm seeing from this defense because their coverage has been playing at a shutdown level so far. Even backed up late, they're forcing incompletions and fighting to keep them at the end zone as the first half winds down.
Now a second down throw for the end zone, but it's incomplete. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at third and 10. To throw again is Jackson. And that's going to be knocked away in the end zone. It's incomplete.
Well, he's smart enough to avoid the taunting rule, but I'm guaranteed.
The offense for the Ravens returns to the field. And following that punt, which turned out as well as it possibly could have, this offense has 99 yards to go to the other end zone.
And the defense is frothing at the mouth with a chance to get points themselves. If they tackle a runner in the end zone, safety. And if there's a holding call in the end zone, that's also a safety as well. So either way you decide to go on offense, you've got to be careful.
Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman.
And I believe they buzzed down. They're going to take another look at this play with all reviews coming from the replay official here in the final 2 minutes of the half. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Well, here's the call.
Now Jackson on first down. Going down the middle, and it's... it's complete. 20. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. A great play there. Already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Ravens have taken the lead. What a first half he is compiling here. He's already over 100 yards receiving and now two touchdowns, CD.
Brandon, you know I don't like to play the game where you start projecting when you're at a certain point. Well, let's face it, he's off to a tremendous start. So 200 yards.
The Raven offense going to take over late in this first half.
And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead. Not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to.
Throwing on first down, it's Jackson. Got a man over the middle, and it's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. A good pickup there, 26 yards.
Barney, you know when we call a game, we talk about Lamar Jackson and his speed and his elusiveness and the ability to get him on the ground, how tough that is for a defense. But how about his development as a thrower, as a professional?
From midfield now, here's Jackson. Wide open receiver complete. Another first down as they call his number again. He's got 15 yards here. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend as we get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. And welcome back to football, everybody. We've got a full slate of 16 games here.
Look around. Out come the Ravens now. They'll go on offense first here in this third quarter.
This offense set to begin the third quarter. And, Charles, if they had a checklist of things they wanted to accomplish in the first half, certainly at the top of that list would be having the lead, and they've got that here.
That's always the most important box to check, isn't it? But also, they've had some success in their passing game, so probably an empty box establishing the run. They're on pace for fewer than 100 yards in this one, so now they want to make sure that they get that going so they truly have a control in this ball game, and down the stretch, being able to be balanced, either throw it or run it, and try and win this ball game.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. Here's Jackson to throw. And oh, he's unable to hold on to that defensively. A potential game changer, but it falls incomplete. Throwing is Jackson. And that will be incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down.
Baltimore about ready to go on offense. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. Throwing now, Jackson on first down. He's going to air one out. He's got a man complete. And he's going to get this down near the 25.
The dynamic duo is doing damage in this one, and they've certainly been on point throughout. And they hook up again for another big play.
Exactly 50 yards on that last play as they just go from 125 to the other for first and 10.
Meanwhile, Jackson's throw into the hands of Boyle here.
And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Not quite the success they had last play. This one goes for 3 yards.
And you know Carter Landry is on the sideline smiling after that one. Remember, the former tight end joined Manny Kahue's offensive staff this spring, and he has been a big advocate of getting the tight ends involved in the passing game.
Yeah, we remember him as a solid tight end in this league for a number of years, and while his playing days just ended, he jumps right into the coaching ranks, and I think he's a great fit and a great get for this offensive staff. With his knowledge and experience, I think he can move up quickly over the next few years. That's not the first time they've gone his way on this drive, and they were obviously keyed into him because they were there to help break that pass up.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had a big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Jackson. And that is incomplete. And so another incompletion there. He's hitting on fewer than half his pass attempts in this one, and that is not a winning formula.
Yeah, so let's make sure we give a little bit of credit to the defense here. They've given him a lot to think about.
And now Baltimore gets set to take the field. Right out of the gate, we're going to get a delay.
Delay of game.
That flag accepted, and it backs the offense up a little bit.
Still first down.
To throw is Jackson. Looking deep downfield. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete.
After what they faced during this game, where they've given up a ton of yards downfield, it has to be a measure of revenge right there for the secondary. They've been shredded throughout the game and finally forced an incompletion.
Behind the sticks here with a second and 15.
Here's Jackson. And that almost their first INT of the ball game. Had his sights on it, but he couldn't seal the deal. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Now it's Jackson. He's got a man complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. Boy, a nice play there as they wind up converting on third and 15.
We have seen big plays from both quarterbacks throughout this game, and there's another one right there. Going back and forth, almost like two excellent guitar soloists trying to top each other with each additional play.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He's going to find his tight end, Boyle. And he'll go down, and that will do it for the third quarter of action. We are through three quarters here on NFL Kickoff Weekend. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here at MetLife Stadium. All even as we get ready to start the fourth. Jackson throwing here complete to Boyle. And he's going to be taken down at the 28-yard line.
Well, that last completion, CD, is now over 400 yards passing in the game. And quite a few of those have come via some pretty big strikes downfield. Certainly not afraid to challenge this secondary, and it's been successful.
Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. A great effort there. With now 3 week 1 touchdowns. And the Ravens have broken our tie and have taken a fourth quarter lead.
This is exactly what they were hoping for when they went after him in free agency. They saw a guy who had the talent but didn't have the targets. But he's going to get some as the season goes on. He's got a touchdown here in week 1.
Baltimore's offense set for this next possession. They no longer have the lead after that last touchdown, all tied up in the fourth quarter, and a chance for this offense to mount a potential game-winning drive right here. They'll throw on first down with Jackson. Short throw into the hands of the tight end, Boyle. And he's able to get this one up to his 30 before he's out of bounds. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And that's going to bring up second down. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Throwing again on second down. Jackson. He'll swing this out to Dobbins. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards to pick up there. Good for a Raven first.
I like what I'm seeing from them here. A tie game in the fourth quarter. They understand the situation. They don't need to be in any rush. Go ahead and huddle up and run your offense. That last completion put them in a nice position to take the lead in this game.
Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. Now this throw caught left side, and he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. That's good for 28 yards. Now a tip of the cap to the man under center, Charles. He just went over 400 yards passing in this ball game. He's got the touchdown passes to boot, taking pretty good care of the ball. Just all around a really solid performance.
Yeah, just check, 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 and check, right? Because he certainly showed he was worthy of the trust that his team put in him. A handful of touchdowns to his credit thus far. Not just causing up yardage milestones and winner moves. His name has to be in serious discussion for player of the game.
So in jet territory now. Here's first and 10, down at the 31. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Ashton Davis. And the Jets are going to get the football here as he gets this up past the 20-yard line. Now the Ravens going to use one of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Baltimore about ready to go on offense. As this offense takes the field against CD, remember last drive, they were moving the football, but then they threw that costly interception, so we'll see if they can right the ship here on this drive.
And doesn't that just sum up football? We see it all the time, don't we? The defense goes from losing the battle to making a huge play and stealing the momentum. So you know they're riding high right now, and they're ready to challenge this offense and that quarterback one more time.
And we'll see if the offense is up for that challenge here as things start to get more interesting here in the second half. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 25 yards that time.
Partner, they're clearly saving those timeouts, but they still have to work with some urgency to put themselves in the right position.
Jackson to throw. He'll check this down to Dobbins out of the backfield. And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40.
It's funny, throughout the time that we've been together, when we talk with running backs about the ability to catch the ball, their eyes light up when they talk about open field and having one-on-one matchups, don't they?
Yeah, they do. And that's the reason why. What we just saw, shedding those tackles, and that's what they're used to doing.
It is, and it starts at the beginning of the play, one-on-one matchup with someone trying to cover them. But they also like those one-on-ones downfield after the catch when they're running with the ball. They think they're going to win those, too.
And he'll be hauled down at about the 30-yard line. The Jets are going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with 1:07 remaining. So first and 10 now from the 30. Jackson. And the coverage terrific there as that's knocked down and incomplete. I guess you can't be afraid to take those chances late in the game. He tried to fit that one in there. Nice job, though, defensively.
But to your point, it was a nice job of knocking the ball away. But you're also right. You can't be afraid to take those chances. That means your guys going downfield to catch the ball, they've got to elevate their game and come down with these in order to keep your offense moving.
Here's Jackson. That's into the hands of the tight end, Boyle. And he's going to be brought down at about the 16. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds left to go in the game. So the ball down to the 16 here for first and 10. Throwing, Jackson. Now, quick throw there, going to be batted away and incomplete.
A little bit of a dangerous throw in a tie ball game because your job, make sure the worst thing that happens to your offense is that you go into overtime. That could have been a game.
And that's going to be caught. Touchdown. And they've broken our tie here in the final minute.
Well, any thoughts about overtime have ended at this juncture. That touchdown puts them up 6. I would imagine they'll kick the extra point now and rely on their defense.
Yeah, rely on their defense. So a little bit of time left on the clock here in the fourth, but they got to feel good now. A little extra excitement for week one, and one of our early window games here in week one on a Sunday comes to a close. Good to be back in the booth with you, my friend.
And it's good to be back in the booth with you as well. And we know that not everyone's going to start the season 1-0, right? Half the league is going to have a loss on their record, but everyone's got to build off of that opener. And how many coaches tell us every single year, you make your most progress between week one and week two. We'll see how both of these teams progress the rest of this season.
So for the Ravens, it was a hard-fought game, and they'll exit 1-0 as they win.
Yeah. So that style not for you, but it's for me.
Greenfield's finest. Boss.
Yeah.
Trauma.
Never let a wishbone grow where backbone should. Belly been taking the dash on wood. Stand pain, it's the back end good. Got sense, but the... Chuck and they all. They might say what's up when they see me around the city, but really no reason to talk much. Dinner and nice guy, but no nice guys here. I'm toe tagging, no Bill Bo back.
And that's why I'm here with